When I first started this long road of basketball, what consumed me was being the best basketball player I could be.
Livingston on his right, Horace Grant on his left. Goes inside.
Oh, classic Jordan!
Classic steal. He lobs for Jordan.
Look at the air. Look at the hang time. Look at the flying motion.
Now, reminiscing about my whole career, I had a whole different appreciation for the game itself.
Jordan trying to shake off Starks. Oh, what a move by Jordan!
He kept it in bounds. Here it is again.
The Bulls win it!
It has evolved to be more than just a game. It's been...
Oh, my goodness!
Michael Jordan, Su Alteza del Aire. Si hubiera que crear la máxima superestrella del baloncesto, sería un jugador con una capacidad atlética extraordinaria. Un jugador que pudiera dominar su deporte con una amplia variedad de destrezas.
He's a great defender, rebounder, shot blocker, definitely could score. He's the total package.
También poseería una ética del trabajo infatigable, empujándose constantemente a sí mismo hasta el límite en su persecución de la victoria.
He'll work himself into a lather, you know, like a racehorse. He'd be going out there harder and harder when things got more and more difficult.
Sería un fiero competidor que mandaría en la cancha por pura fuerza de voluntad.
You're going to have to cut Michael Jordan's heart out to beat him.
Poseería la visión y el arte para aportar al juego una nueva dimensión.
Creativity, thy name is Michael.
También tendría el liderazgo para galvanizar a sus compañeros.
The way he plays, he will not let the Bulls lose.
Y tendría el instinto de aprovechar una oportunidad detrás de otra.
Michael Jordan in the final seconds again.
Demostraría pasión por el juego. Pasión por elevar su actuación al nivel más alto. Y cautivaría a su público no solo con su talento, sino también con su carisma.
Just don't rub my head.
Lo sabría llevar todo con un aire de gracia y dignidad que le convertiría en el embajador perfecto para el deporte que amaba. Parecería casi imposible encontrar todas estas cualidades personificadas en un jugador. Y sin embargo, semejante jugador se encontró en Michael Jordan. Un jugador para el que nada parecía imposible. Un jugador que era la propia definición de la excelencia en el baloncesto.
He does everything great. I mean, he's the ultimate player in my eyes. If there was a, you know, basketball player in Webster's dictionary, it didn't have to be a picture of Michael Jordan.
Creció en Wilmington, Carolina del Norte. Y desde el principio hubo algo único en Michael Jordan.
He came in this world eating. I mean, he loved to eat. And I tell you, he could not feed him enough. We had the doctor put him on cereal, I guess, when he was 3 weeks old, because his milk was just not enough.
El primer contacto de Michael con el deporte del baloncesto lo tuvo jugando con su hermano mayor Larry, que encendió su fuego competitivo.
My dad built the basketball court in the backyard, so they went out there and went at it all the time.
We used to play an awful lot, you know, we would play every day. And I would normally beat him.
Well, he really helped me create some determination in myself to beat him. If I could beat him, I felt I could beat anybody. And finally, when I started to grow and my skills started to catch up with my height, I started to beat him.
Asistió al Instituto Lani, donde se integró como un rostro más en la multitud.
Michael was a good student, and he had a lot of fun in the classroom. He had a sense of humor, and he was well liked by the students.
El lugar en el que Michael esperaba destacar era la cancha de baloncesto, pero en su segundo año se enfrentaría a un decepcionante obstáculo.
I'm the coach who cut Michael as a sophomore. He was still growing, he was a good ball player, but we didn't think he was good enough yet to really make the contribution on the varsity that we felt we needed.
Trabajando duro para mejorar, Michael no solo ingresaría en el equipo el año siguiente, sino que jugó tan bien como para ganar una beca de la Universidad de Carolina del Norte. Una escuela con una rica tradición en baloncesto, pero todavía se enfrentaba al escepticismo sobre su habilidad.
I told him to go into math. That's where the money was.
Coming up in high school, I wasn't that known as a basketball player. I mean, everyone felt I was going to go to North Carolina, sit on the bench for 4 years, and then come back home and work at a local gas station or something.
Pero Michael fue elegido para empezar como novato por el legendario entrenador Dean Smith. Y en el partido contra Georgetown del campeonato nacional, saltaría al primer plano al lograr una de las mejores canastas de la historia de la NCAA. Ese tiro dio a Dean Smith su primer título de la NCAA y marcó un punto crucial en la carrera de Michael.
Hitting a shot against Georgetown in 1982, it kind of ignited a fire inside of me that nothing was going to stop me.
Impulsado por su nueva confianza, Jordan saltaría entonces a la palestra nacional.
He wanted to get better, and then he had the ability to get better. And from that point on, I never seen anything like it.
I guess that is a pretty fitting end to the ball game. Jordan, look at that!
Desplegando su talento, Michael se convirtió en el jugador universitario del año en dos ocasiones. Pero después de su tercer año, tomó la decisión de hacerse profesional.
I talked to coach this morning, and he helped me, and my parents helped me, and I felt that would be better for me to start now while I'm young.
Pero antes de encaminarse a la NBA, haría su debut internacional. Fue seleccionado para el equipo olímpico de Estados Unidos en 1984, donde tuvo como guía a otra leyenda de entrenador, Bobby Knight de Indiana.
He wants the best for his players, and really, that's somewhat similar to Coach Smith, except for the language, but, I can get up with that.
Adaptándose suavemente al nuevo estilo de entrenamiento, Michael continuaría elevándose hacia el estrellato al conducir a Estados Unidos a la medalla de oro. Y ya estaba listo para el siguiente paso de su floreciente carrera, la NBA.
The Chicago Bulls pick Michael Jordan.
Como tercer jugador seleccionado, se esperaba que Michael causara impacto, pero pocos podían imaginar lo sensacional que llegaría a ser. Tomando la liga al ataque, Jordan electrizaría su deporte de un modo que pocos atletas habían hecho antes.
There's the double.
Jordan, Michael!
Jordan against Dale Ellis, off to the right. Jordan on the drive, falls down underneath.
Jordan. Oh, what a drive. Oh, what a drive.
And Ewing wants the ball and gets it. Bad out of bounds.
Woo! Jordan on the drive. Can he get there?
Can he get there?
Para Michael parecía que todo era posible y ya en su segunda temporada llevaría a cabo una actuación épica en la eliminatoria.
63 for Jordan. A new NBA record has been set in the Boston Garden.
I don't believe what I just saw. I saw man fly.
Here comes Mr. Jordan.
Action.
Well, I think he's probably the most exciting player that's come into this league since probably Dr. J. Hopefully I can make a name for myself and not try to live off his name. I think Michael Jordan sounds pretty good to me.
Tras unos pocos años ya se le mencionaba como uno de los grandes de todos los tiempos.
You had two players that played on the floor that excited you by their play on the floor, myself and Larry. And now here come one that excites you playing in the air.
Michael Jordan cleared for takeoff.
Well, first of all, you start talking about the fact that the guy literally is embarrassing the league. He's that good.
Gets it away to Jordan. Oh, showtime for Mr. Jordan. Jordan to the hoop. Oh!
You might see something if you watched him that you'd never seen before and will never see again.
Look at the air. Look at the hang time. Look at the flying motion.
Stepped it out to Jordan down the lane all the way.
Oh, good! An unbelievable ball.
He has a force of personality that's not the same thing as sports talent, but elevates that talent. If you didn't know anything about basketball and he walked into the room, you'd say, that's somebody. That's got to be somebody.
El atractivo de Jordan trascendía al baloncesto. Se convirtió en un fenómeno cultural que se extendió al mundo del marketing y los medios de comunicación. Se había convertido incluso en un marcador de tendencias.
You know, he had his own particular style. He wore those baggy shorts. He was one of the first athletes to shave his head. He was so good, so charismatic, that whatever he did suddenly became popular and became cool.
I know, something about the combination of everything, you know. The game, obviously. He was a tremendous athlete. And he had a great smile. Something very wonderful and warm about when he smiled. And he really communicated well with the camera.
It was great. I mean, who wouldn't want to be in commercials or want to see your posters or your billboards all over the place? You know, I'm just a country boy from North Carolina, and to be on television and do these things were great.
Nobody in the world could cover my main man, Michael Jordan. Nobody.
I always wanted to be an easygoing guy. My personality is that I'm outgoing. I love people. I love being around people. I love kids. So if I didn't have the personality to do it, it would be tough. But my personality fits this mold very easily.
Parecía que sus admiradores nunca se cansaban de ver partidos de la última superestrella, y Air Jordan nunca les dejaba insatisfechos.
In a league of stars, in a game of stars, you were the star of stars. Congratulations on being the 1988 All-Star MVP.
Jordan había alcanzado el estatus de superestrella. Sin embargo, en su currículum faltaba el único logro que cimentaría su puesto entre la élite de los jugadores.
What separated me from Larry Bird and Magic Johnson was, you know, they had championships to back their individual accolades. So, I mean, that drove me more so than anything.
To compete, to win, it's all I live for, really.
Wide left, Pippen, 3 seconds, Jordan's force-up shot to left.
Oh, court. Yes!
Win. Michael Jordan saves the day.
When you lose, you know, you're easily forgotten, and I don't think anyone wants.
Encontró con un gran obstáculo que le seguía bloqueando el camino.
People forget how hard it was for that guy to deal with the Detroit Pistons. You know, they were the one person that's saying, you're not so hot, you know, we can stop you. And they did.
Well, the Pistons have moved on, but you really got a feel for this man right here.
Durante 3 años seguidos, los Bulls se enfrentaron a los Pistons en la eliminatoria. Y durante 3 años seguidos sufrieron una amarga derrota.
Chicago Bulls continue to frustrate themselves and their fans.
I felt it was very disappointing each and every time that we ended up getting to this hurdle and couldn't get over it.
The Pistons return to the NBA Finals for the third straight time.
Cada año que pasaba, la frustración de Michael se hacía más profunda. A la vez que crecían los rumores de que Jordan era un fenómeno aislado, que no podía transmitir su actuación a su equipo.
I had to contend with people saying, well, a scoring champion doesn't win championships, which drove me nuts.
Defensively, the Pistons are pointing totally at Michael Jordan. They don't believe that any of the other four Bulls can hurt them at this point.
You can tell when we're beating him, he's looking around like, I'm doing all I can do. I'm getting 60 points, 45 points, 39 points, and we're still losing.
Cuando empezaba la temporada de 1991, Jordan comprendió que hacía falta un cambio si los Bulls querían cumplir con su destino.
I felt that we were going to lose out on this opportunity in terms of, you know, my leadership and what I had to do on the basketball court. I was going to do whatever I had to do to get us a championship.
Se concentraría en involucrar más a sus compañeros y aprovechar al máximo sus talentos.
Powerhouse!
Cualquier cosa que les faltara a los Bulls la suplía Jordan y alcanzaron mejor puntuación que nunca.
If you need something done, I do it. You know, defense, passing, scoring, whatever. That was the challenge that I took.
De vuelta a las finales de la conferencia se encontraron con sus torturadores, los Pistons, aguardándoles de nuevo, pero esta vez las cosas serían diferentes.
Pistons with the numbers. Edwards lost it. Oh, Jordan stripped the dribble. Hacks it over. Yes. The Bulls on fire.
Jordan with Dumars. Takes him into the lane. Hands it off to Horace Grant. Inside, he lays it in. Yes, sir. McGuire baseline right, doubled up, had it chopped away. Hart wide ahead to Jordan. Michael in the drive, in on Vinnie Johnson, all the way to the hoop and lays it in. Oh, there's panic all over the Pistons' faces.
Finalmente, los Bulls ganaron su revancha, barriendo en cuatro partidos y dejando tras ellos la pesadilla de los Pistons.
That's could be the nail in the coffin.
I remember looking directly in his eyes, and it was like, whatever you do, whatever you say, we're gonna beat you. And once you get him like that, all you can do is move aside because there's no stopping this freight train.
The Detroit Pistons heading back to the locker room. Their season has concluded while the Chicago Bulls advance to the NBA championship round.
Cuando hizo su debut en la final de la NBA, la sincronización de Michael fue perfecta. Se enfrentaría a Magic Johnson y a los Lakers en lo que sería el último viaje a la final de Magic.
This series tends to be, at least in the public mind, Air Jordan against the Magic Man.
There's no question, you're not going to avoid the Magic Michael thing.
We're going to take our friends and fans on a trip into Dreamland, Magic and Michael.
Magic había conducido a sus Lakers a 5 títulos en los años 80. Si Michael quería heredar su manto como superestrella principal de la NBA, ahora era el momento de hacerlo, y todo el mundo del deporte lo estaría mirando.
We didn't feel like the pressure was on us, but the challenge was there. Yeah, especially for myself. You know, here I'm going against one of the greatest players in the game, and I want to beat him.
Con la oportunidad delante, Michael aceptaría el reto e incentivaría a sus compañeros de los Bulls a someter a los Lakers.
Devontae with a bounce pass in Jordan, the steal, tight ropes the sideline, all the way to the hoop for the dunk. A spectacular play by Jordan.
The Bulls have exploded.
Showtime as he skies into the air, and Air Jordan throws it down.
Michael y los Bulls ganarían su primer campeonato.
The look away to Livingston.
Ahora la antorcha de la supremacía en la NBA había pasado enfáticamente de Johnson a Jordan.
Everybody knew that it was coming. It's just when. When was he going to be ready to receive it and take it? And boy, did he receive it and take it. I mean, he came up and snatched it here. Give it here, Magic. It's my turn now.
And the Chicago Bulls have won their first ever.
Se dio una aura aún más heroica.
I think the fact that he failed the first few times he took a run at the title made people connect to him and relate to him a little bit better because they saw that he wasn't just this machine. I mean, everyone's failed at certain things, and to see a star of his magnitude fail and feel it so deeply raised his stature in people's minds.
Parecía que los admiradores celebraban el triunfo de Michael por todas partes.
From a public acceptance, you're never a champion until you are a champion. And once that burden was gone, he just soared to even greater heights that it's just hard to imagine.
As a member of this team and an organization in the city of Chicago for 7 years, it brings me great joy to say we are the world champions. Thank you.
Michael y los Bulls izaron al final el pendón de la victoria. Pero cuando empezó la 92ª temporada, quedó claro que su ansia por ganar aún no estaba satisfecha.
It's like the guy on King of the Hill situation. Once you're on top of the hill, You want to defend it.
Habiendo finalmente llegado a la cima de la NBA, Jordan estaba decidido a permanecer allí.
Michael, you know, he really took matters in his own hands right there to stretch out the game.
Here comes Jordan, behind the back pocket. What a play! What a play! How does he do that? How does he do that? How does he know?
Whenever it's time for Michael to take over a game, you know, he takes it over.
You know, and just let us know that, hey, I'm feeling it, I'm feeling good. It's my game. I love it.
Michael condujo a Chicago a la mejor puntuación de la liga y a lo largo del proceso aprovechó para inflar su creciente lista de logros personales.
3 MVPs, 6 straight scoring titles. You are simply the standard by which basketball excellence is measured. Congratulations.
Chicago Stadium, the site tonight as the Bulls begin defense of their NBA championship.
Biggest focus of the season is the playoffs. I thrive on it. I love it. It's a joy for me to step in front of that camera when you know millions of people are watching and show the skills and the creativity that you have as an athlete.
Jordan drives again.
Mientras los Bulls superaban con facilidad el calor de Miami, Jordan se encontraba en su mejor forma.
Goes inside.
Classic Michael Jordan.
Ante Patrick Ewing y sus peleones Knicks, se mostraría más decidido que nunca.
Oh, he is ripped by Starks.
Patrick is one of my best friends, but yet, at one point in time in that series, I was ready to go blows with him.
A pesar del juego físico duro de Nueva York, Jordan se negaba a que le intimidaran. En cualquier caso, su estrategia solo servía para inspirarle todavía más.
Here's Jordan, splitting through. Jordan with the steal. And then it's stolen by Starks. McDaniel chased by Jordan. It's a clean block. Whose game is it? It's Michael Jordan's game.
Pero se reservaría su actuación más dramática para el acto final. En un duelo con la superestrella rival Clyde Drexler y los Trail Blazers de Portland.
Jordan against Drexler, Clyde against Michael.
See, this is what Michael lived for. He wanted this challenge.
Everyone was saying that, you know, this would determine who's the better guard in the league. I looked at that as a challenge, and hopefully by the end of that series, people understood the difference.
Y no perdería el tiempo despejando dudas. Montó un gran espectáculo desde el principio.
Jordan.
Con su explosión ofensiva, Jordan impulsó a los Bulls a su segundo título seguido y alzó su propia popularidad a nuevas cotas. Pero lo increíble es que aún subiría más. Ese verano se uniría a Larry Bird y Magic Johnson en el fabuloso Dream Team.
You can't get too close to Michael, it's a foul.
Pero incluso en tan afamada compañía, era Jordan el que ocupaba el lugar central en un frenesí de atención internacional.
We didn't know the hype that was in store for us. Until we started traveling around, we see helicopters and motorcades all over the place. Hey, this is big. You know, this is bigger than what we ever anticipated.
I mean, Beatlesque was about the only thing you can think of, and I just have never seen anything like it. But the one thing about Jordan that I would always say that makes him to me the most remarkable athlete that I've ever seen and probably ever will see is that he was always better than his hype. Okay, so now he's hyped even more, but he gets even better. he keeps getting better and better and better no matter what you do. I just have never seen anything like it.
This group may well be the greatest team ever assembled in the history of team sports.
Michael coronó las Olimpiadas con su segunda medalla de oro. Pero no iba a detenerse allí, puesto que su fuego competitivo seguía ardiendo.
It's been 8 years going into my ninth year, and we got 2 championships, and hopefully we got a lot left.
Al comenzar la temporada de 1993, Jordan añadiría imágenes aún más asombrosas a su infinita y continua galería de hitos.
Yes, here comes Mike.
Here's Jordan in deep on Elo.
Oh, yeah! Oh!
Bounds the cart right to Jordan, time winding down. Michael for three. Yeah! 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 Yes! 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 A winner! Unbelievable!
Michael, what would you like to do?
La temporada completa parecía estar a las órdenes de Jordan.
It's an unbelievable sight to be pulling into a hotel at 3 in the morning on the bus. You get there, turn around the corner, and all of a sudden, the whole street is lit up. You think, wow, they're filming a movie out here or something. Well, it's not. It's just that the Bulls are arriving. Michael Jordan, they have a chance maybe to see him.
En la postemporada conduciría de nuevo a los Bulls a las finales con su característico estilo. Pero que Chicago jugara por el campeonato de la NBA se había convertido en lo natural.
He is amazing.
La final del 93 le traería a Michael una nueva y entretenida estrella.
God want us to win the world championship.
I don't know if I go that far, Charles.
I talked to him the other night.
Sin embargo, ni siquiera la intervención divina era suficiente. Jordan atacaría implacablemente a Charles Barkley y los Suns.
Underneath, Michael fights and scores with a left hand.
Michael Jordan now looks like he is going to drive every time he gets his hand on a ball until they stop it.
Su ofensiva le reportaría un récord personal en una final de 55 puntos en el cuarto partido.
Michael will take it. He's fouled. He scores. He threw it up. Off balance and went in. Oh my, Michael with his fist clit near midcourt.
I tell you, he's just simply amazing. He does whatever he has to do to beat you.
We cannot stop him. I never said we had to stop him. Well, we can't stop
focus
him.
On
Nobody
him.
Can stop him.
Los Bulls conseguirían el título en 6 partidos, sellándolo de forma dramática.
Paxson going for the win.
Here's Paxson for three.
Paxson.
Yes!
Yes!
It's the three.
That's the first score by anybody other than Michael Jordan in the entire fourth quarter.
Michael había alcanzado ya la cumbre de su carrera.
For the third year, Michael Jordan and the Chicago Bulls have climbed the Mount Olympus of the NBA.
Reforzando su estatus como mejor jugador de baloncesto, Jordan había logrado lo que Bird y Magic no consiguieron, ganar un tercer título seguido, un acontecimiento que no había sucedido desde el gran Celtics de Bill Russell en los años 60.
Congratulations, it's a great accomplishment.
Parecía que lo tenía todo. Pero Michael aún no había dado su paso más asombroso.
After we won the championship, and I sat in on the floor and just reminisced about the whole season and the years that I've had at the game of basketball and where my life was and where my challenges were. Do I have to do anything else? Can I just sit here for a few minutes?
It started weighing me down mentally because of all the things that were happening and some of the responsibility that I was gaining, the expectations. Mentally, I was exhausted because I forgot where I was. I forgot how I got there because of being on top for so long. You forget about a lot of the stages and the steps that it took to get to that point. And my father and I had a conversation about just stepping away.
Jordan había llegado a una encrucijada. Se pasaría el verano reflexionando sobre sus sentimientos.
I wanted to give myself some time to make sure this was the right thing, this is what I really wanted to do. I asked Phil Jackson, frankly, I said, what kind of challenges can you give me next year? If you can give me one challenge, I would not retire.
He felt like if I don't have the desire to do it, if I don't have the thirst to play basketball, and it's not as much fun as it used to be, then I'm going to lose my gift.
We were crying and trying to come up with different types of challenges, and I couldn't come up with one. He couldn't come up with one for me.
El sentimiento de angustia con el que Michael luchaba mientras se decidía palidecería en comparación con lo que estaba a punto de sucederle.
Last night we began the show with the disappearance of Michael Jordan's father. Tonight the worst fears have come true. James Jordan was found dead, the victim of an apparent murder.
It was a very difficult moment for me, and somehow I just kept my head high and the education that he gave me, and I thought about all the things that he used to tell me. Just turn a negative into a positive. And here I was dealing with him in that way. It was tough.
Abatido por la muerte de su padre, que siempre había sido su consejero y apoyo más próximo, su elección quedó clara. Pronto el mundo la conocería.
When I lose the sense of motivation and the sense of to prove something as a basketball player, it's time for me to move away from the game of basketball.
It was something that, you know, my father and I talked about way before he passed. Me retiring from basketball and then playing baseball. And the final year that we won the championship was like his biggest push to go and do it. No one could present a challenge for me at the time other than what my father was presenting to me, which was to go and play baseball.
Siguiendo el consejo de su padre, Michael se haría jugador de béisbol de segunda división. Más que una simple diversión, su nuevo pasatiempo era parte de un viaje emocional.
I think what baseball did for me was it gave me an opportunity to revisit all those moments that I had with my father. And when I really thought about it, I said, he was here. You know, everything that he's taught me, everything that I accomplished was him. It took me a while to understand that. And once I understood it, I could accept it and deal with it. So it was a therapeutic experience for me. I guess it made me at peace with myself.
Pero en marzo de 1995 dejaría el béisbol y volvería a Chicago.
He calls me about 7 in the morning and says, you know, hey, let's go to breakfast. So we go to breakfast, we talk a little bit. He's in a suit. So, you know, he said, let's go over to practice and screw around before practice. Like, all right, fine, you know, we'll do that. You know, no problem. So we're out there just shooting. He has his suit on still. I have my practice stuff on. So shooting, a shooting game goes into a shooting contest. Then all of a sudden the contest goes into, well, let me see if you can still guard me. And then it goes from, well, let me see if you can still guard me. And then before you know it, we're playing a one-on-one.
I'd started attending a couple of practices and getting out there with the guys, and the enjoyment that came out of that really started to make me feel good.
The economy has produced 6.1 million jobs since I became president. And if Michael Jordan goes back to the Bulls, it'll be 6,100,001 new jobs.
Michael Jordan announced today he's coming back to basketball.
One guy said the words, I'm back. And it set the world on fire, just turned it upside down.
I never thought I'd come back to the game of basketball. I never thought I would have that feeling to come.
Tras una ausencia de 18 meses, Jordan regresó y su retorno encendió una chispa mágica.
Here's Jordan. Bulls trail by one. Michael. Oh yeah. Welcome back. Michael Jordan.
Recuperó instantáneamente las imágenes indelebles del pasado.
Yes.
A high for the NBA this season. 55 points by Michael Jordan.
The inbounds to Michael, racing the clock. Jordan for the win.
Yes! I did it again! He is now back!
Jordan había recuperado aparentemente su papel de salvador. En la eliminatoria, el joven Magic de Orlando estaba listo para demostrar que los tiempos habían cambiado.
91-90 the score. Chicago with the lead with 18.1 seconds to play.
All right, here we go. Now Jordan played by Anderson. And Jordan spinning his way against Anderson. And Michael Jordan.
El error de Jordan parecía casi impensable, pero tendría otra ocasión más para exhibir sus esperados heroísmos.
Jordan,
pride was in those moments that, you know, you take pride in being put in, and yet I let the team down.
Michael y los Bulls nunca se recuperarían de sus esfuerzos en el primer partido.
A lot of close-in shots, and he's tried to take the game over.
Cuando Chicago fue eliminado por Magic, Jordan descubrió que su habilidad única para alzar a su equipo con la victoria era solo un recuerdo. Ahora tenía que preguntarse si podría recuperar su trono alguna vez.
Give him credit. He's probably still the greatest player in the game overall. But he wasn't his old self.
I was very demoralized, I think, and I was really looking in the mirror the whole time. I had doubts that maybe I can't play the same type of game that I used to play because I wasn't able to do it on call. So in sitting in that locker room and very disappointed, I made a promise to myself that come next year, I'm gonna be ready for this game.
Consagrándose de nuevo al baloncesto, Jordan se cebó con saña en los entrenamientos. Se pasó el verano calibrando su talento como nunca.
I felt compelled each and every day when I got up to go out and somehow tune up and get back to where I was. So I was that much more motivated to prove to the world that don't write me off yet.
Cuando se reunió con sus compañeros para la temporada de 1996, Michael se estaba embarcando no solo en una búsqueda personal, sino en una misión histórica.
I said to Mike, it's a great challenge anyway, because no one's come back and helped the team win a championship. So this is a great challenge in that regard.
I was being judged on that from the public, from the media, because of my age and because of my being away from the game for 2 years.
MJ between them all! He got every one of them!
Yes!
Jordan picked it off behind the back.
He's in his own zone today, and it was good.
Three on the shot clock. Here comes Michael, puts it on the floor, pull up 16-footer. Put two more down for the King. He is the man.
Here is Jordan. Michael tonight is showing the entire repertoire.
With Michael on our side, it was, you know, guys are on the bench the whole game saying, oh, we're only 12 down, you know, we're going to come back.
Jordan going and throws it up. Harris getting, puts it in on an amazing move.
This guy was back in his full force as the most dominant player in the game.
No solo había vuelto su dominio, sino también su pasión por el juego.
Come on, I'll give you a jump shot right now. I'll give you a jump shot, shoot. Well, you don't want it. Hey, my boy don't want to play, do it. He hurting this boy. You're hurting it, y'all.
Oh, I got it.
Su regreso se convirtió en una marcha triunfal cuando Michael recuperó el premio MVP e introdujo a los Bulls en la historia de la NBA con un récord de victorias en la temporada. Guiando a los Bulls a unas asombrosas 72 victorias, Jordan los marcó como uno de los mejores equipos de todos los tiempos. Y al mismo tiempo elevó su prestigio todavía más.
He was up at the very top, the most popular athlete in the world for 8, 9, 10 years. He leaves the game and comes back stronger than ever. I don't think anyone in the history of sport has ever pulled off something like that. And the guy, and he did it again somehow.
En la eliminatoria, Michael cerraría de nuevo el círculo. Enfrentándose a Orlando le proporcionaría la oportunidad de redimirse. Borrando el recuerdo de las derrotas de los Bulls en años anteriores, los Bulls barrieron a los Magic en la final de la Conferencia del Este. Jordan estaba ya a punto de completar su cruzada. Y enfrentándose a los Supersonics de Seattle, en el máximo acontecimiento de la NBA, despejaría cualquier duda de que seguía siendo el Michael Jordan de siempre.
Michael Jordan is in another time, in another space, on another plateau.
Y al conducir a Chicago a la victoria sobre Seattle, el retorno de Michael quedaba completado.
Ever. for the fourth time in 6 years, Jordan rules. After a two-year absence, the Chicago Bulls have regained the NBA throne.
Marcaba la culminación de un viaje que había comenzado con su retirada. Apropiada y simbólicamente, había terminado en el Día del Padre.
I think it was a signal to some degree that he was there with me. It was a certain emotions that I couldn't really control, knowing that, you know, the success of it was had something to do with him, you know, and that meant a lot to me.
Michael, I know that the first one was sweet, but how much sweeter was this one?
Well, you know, I can't even put it in words. My father's there, what it means to me. I know he's watching. This is for Daddy.
God-given abilities, and then his own self-drive to make him even better than that is something that takes him off the scale.
He is the most tenacious competitor. Add that to his physical gifts, and he has a sense of history and a sense of what his legacy can be if he keeps pushing it.
Michael on the drive. Beautiful. Right by everybody with the left hand.
There's something compelling about this guy, so likable. So dignified and classy, and yet with the athletic heart of an assassin.
Tell me I can no longer fly. I want you to.
It's not how hard you push along the way. It's having something in you to finish.
Michael Jordan había recuperado su puesto como principal jugador de la NBA. Había ganado el título y logrado uno de los retornos más grandes del deporte. Pero como es habitual, tenía la intención de lograr todavía más.
Jordan
proporcionaría un tipo diferente de espectáculo en el quinto partido. Debilitado por un virus estomacal, mantendría a los Bulls dentro del juego mediante pura voluntad y determinación.
As a leader, you want to be there for your team. As long as I'm able to walk and run and shoot, I've always been there. Sick, you know, didn't matter.
Con la puntuación empatada en el minuto final y un Jordan agotado, reuniría fuerzas y asestaría el golpe final.
Back, Michael. Open three. Yes. Oh. They lead it! 38 points for the Kings!
Stuck a dagger at him with a three! Yes!
That he gave us today was unbelievable, you know, as his teammates. We really appreciate the way that he steps up and shows his leadership for our ball club.
Con Michael ganando su quinto premio de la final MVP, los Bulls consiguieron su quinto premio. Pero incluso en aquel momento de triunfo, flotaba una pregunta. ¿Cuánto tiempo seguirá jugando Jordan?
Do you think you guys will get together and do it all again?
Oh, tough question to ask us right now. We're just enjoying
Enjoy
what we're
yourself.
Doing.
Celebrate. Go ahead and celebrate.
Yes.
Entre rumores acerca de su retirada, la temporada de 1998 se vio envuelta en un aire de despedida para Jordan. Durante toda la liga, la multitud se congregaba en cifras récord para presenciar lo que se creía su último baile. Disfrutando de su papel como embajador, la popularidad de Michael nunca había sido tan grande ni su aura tan inmensa. Fue el foco de atención durante toda la temporada. Y cada noche dejaba a sus admiradores una actuación inolvidable.
Lots of guys are strong and lots of guys have skill and only one guy has this level of artistry.
En el partido All-Star en Nueva York obtuvo el premio MVP por tercera vez.
I'm only going to allow him to have his trophy if he promises to come back and do it again.
Y con Michael dirigiendo a los Bulls, apuntaban a otro campeonato de la NBA.
You don't find leaders like that in this game. You don't find people that want to practice and lead and practice as well as in games.
aunque sería su última temporada, nunca bajó del listón que había dejado tan alto y siguió actuando con su estilo incomparable.
His game is beautiful to watch, not just effective in an athletic sense, but theatrically he is beautiful. He has that presence. There's something about him.
Kittles against Jordan, knocked away, stolen by Michael. MJ on the right. Michael dumps the ball and a foul. Oh my!
I've seen every basket that Michael's made as a professional. You think you see him do something he's done before, and then you say, no, this is something he made up, it's different. I just find myself as a fan jumping out of my seat.
A la edad de 35 años, Jordan se convirtió en el jugador más viejo en ganar. Pero con Chicago ganando por 3-2, se reservaría para el final una de sus actuaciones más notables. En el sexto partido en Utah, los Bulls perdían por 3 puntos, a menos de un minuto de acabar. Enfrentándose a un momento crítico, Michael añadiría un emocionante capítulo final a su leyenda.
Out front to the man, Michael Jordan. Jordan up top, fake left, go right. He's there, lay it up, score it easily. Wow.
A lo largo de toda su carrera ha respondido a todos los desafíos. Y con su resolución a...
Jordan knocks it away from him. Jordan's got it. The Bulls can win it right here. The Bulls can win it. Unbelievable.
Fires. Yes! He scores! The Bulls lead 87-86. The Chicago Bulls have won their 6th NBA championship in the last 8 years.
Oh my God, that was beautiful. What a beautiful.
His legend just
holy cow.
He's been remarkable. What a joy to watch.
That may have been the last shot Michael Jordan will ever take in the NBA.
I am here to announce my retirement from the game of basketball.
For the second time in his career, Michael Jordan caps a championship three-peat with retirement.